We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Hello everyone, I am Bhavin Trivedi from GIDC Degree Engineering College. Due to COVID-19 and because of lockdown, some of the theories are left to teach you. In online session, we have seen introduction of DC to DC converter, but detailed discussion is left. So let's see here today. So first converter is buck converter, which is also known as step down converter. Buck converter, or you can say step down converter. Why it is step down? Because it step down the voltage. We are getting less voltage from, if whenever we require less voltage then input voltage, at that time we have to use this buck converter. Or you can say step function of step down converter is to convert less output voltage than your input voltage. This is a function of buck converter, and that's why it's called step down converter also, because it converts less output voltage, or it gives a less output voltage than your input voltage. So here you can see this is the circuit of buck converter: input voltage, switch, diode, inductor, capacitor, and this is your our load, output voltage. So to know the relationship between this input output voltage and this input voltage, we need to know the voltage across the inductor. Why voltage across the inductor we need to know? Because it gives us the input output voltage relationship. It gives the input voltage output, input and output voltage relationship. So from that we can know how much voltage we require. Accordingly we can convert the less output voltage. Okay, so let's see how it converts. This is your supply voltage, input voltage, switch. This switch may be IGBT, MOSFET, GTO, or you can say any self commutating switch. Okay, this switch is self commutating switch, IGBT, MOSFET, BJT, GTO, any of them. So when switch is on, so whenever I am giving the gate pulse to this switch, the switch will become turn on and current will flow in this direction, in this direction. Okay, so whenever the switch is on, voltage across the inductor at this point is Vin, and at second terminal voltage across the inductor will be this V0. This V0 will reflect at the second terminal of inductor, and at the first terminal, as switch is on, voltage across the at first terminal voltage across the inductor is Vin. So ultimately when switch is on, voltage across the inductor is Vin minus V0. Okay, so whenever switch is on, voltage across the inductor is Vin minus V0 into DTS. DTS is a on period of the switches, and 1 minus D into TS is off period of the switches. When that means whenever your switch is off, so that is 1 minus D into TS period. This is a off period, and D into TS is on period. So now let's say I am removing the gate pulse. I am removing the gate pulse, that means this switch is off. Switch is off, that means what? Yes, this switch is open. Open, so at the first terminal of your inductor, how much voltage is reflecting? 0. At this terminal, 0 voltage is reflecting. Why? Because your input source is disconnected. Supply is disconnected. This is open. So it is a 0 here. And at second terminal, again, that whatever the voltage across the load, that will reflect at the second terminal. So Vin 0, 0 minus V 0 into 1 minus D into TS, because this is an off period of the switch. So ultimately, whenever the switch is off, voltage across the inductor is minus V 0 into 1 minus D into TS. Hope you get it. Now, to find the relationship between the input and output voltage, we have to equate these two equations. We want to find the input-output voltage relationship. So for that, we have to equate these two equations. So Vin minus V0 into dTs plus minus V0 1 minus D into TS equals to 0. So if you will do some mathematical manipulation, you will get this relation. V0 is equal to Vin into D. What is D? D is, as you all know, D is duty ratio. Duty ratio means it is a ratio of on period divided by total time period. On period divided by total time period. So D is duty ratio. So here we are getting, in buck converter, we are getting this relationship. Means output voltage equals to input voltage into D. So output voltage depends on these two parameters. Which parameter? Input voltage and duty ratio. Input voltage, whatever it may be, 100, 200. So whatever the duty ratio is there, accordingly you can convert your output voltage. Let's see some example. If Vin is equal to 100 volt, means input battery voltage is 100 volt, then how much voltage I will get at the output side? So if input voltage is 100 volt, what will be the value of V0, means what will be the value of output voltage for these three cases? If duty ratio is 0, duty ratio is 0.5 and 1. So let's say if D equals to 0, duty ratio is 0, that means what? T on by total time period. Duty ratio is total time on period divided by total time. So if from equation 1 you can see that if you put D equals to 0 here, then output voltage you will get 0 volt from equation 1. And D is equal to 0, that means what? You are not turning on this switch. D equals to 0. It is open, totally open. You are not giving any gate pulse. In that case only you are getting D equals to 0. Okay, so D equals to 0. So that your switch is permanently open. You are... So here V0 is equal to 0 volt. Now let's say D is equal to 0.5. Means 50%. D is equal to 0.5. What does it indicate? You are turning on switches for 0.5, means 50% time period is switch on and another 50% of time this switch is off. So 0.5, for D is equal to 0.5, from equation 1, input is 100 volt, so you will get V0 is equal to 50 volt. 100 into 0.5 is a 50 volt. Okay, now let's say third case, D is equal to 1. D is equal to 1. So if you will put here D is equal to 1, you will get V0 is equal to Vin into 1, means 100 into 1. So it is, you will get 100 volt. And D equals to 1, what it will indicate? You are continuously, D is equal to 1 means you are T on upon total time period. And T on is equal to when you will get D is equal to 1, that means permanently your switch is on. Only that time you will get D is equal to 1. This D is equal to 1 is, that means your switch is permanently on. Okay, then only you will get D is equal to 1. There is no off period. D equals to 1 means there is no off period, only on period, permanently on. D is equal to 0 means permanently open, or you can say permanently off. Okay, and 0.5 means your 50% time period is, for 50% time period switch is on, and for 50% time period switch is off. So from this equation example we can see that you are max whenever your switch is on permanently, only that time only you are getting input voltage is equal to output voltage. Okay, see, from the it is equal to 1 means you are permanently switch on, so your maximum voltage you are getting is same as your input voltage. Here we are ignoring switches loss, switch is ideal, LNC will work as a filter, we are ignoring the diode losses. So ideal, in ideal cases we are getting 100 volt for D equals to 1. Okay, so here we in buck converter, by changing this duty ratio, we can convert output voltage as per our requirement. Okay, but maximum voltage we can get same as your input voltage at the output side. Otherwise, in other case, if your duty ratio is less than 1, every time you will get less voltage than your input voltage. So this is a buck converter. So here you are getting always lesser voltage than your input voltage in buck converter. Hope you understand it, and if any query, then you can contact me or you can comment. Thank you.